Welcome to another Vintage Cube Draft using our Denver Cube, the Mile High Cube, as some call it. What do we got? We got Caracas, we have Time Warp, Preordain, Rofellos, Fabled Passage. Fabled Passage isn't bad. It's a lot worse than Prismatic Beastall, like a lot worse. Karn is one of the cards that's lost so much value over as spells have gotten better. What do we take first here? Fabled Passage keeps us even a little bit more open than Caracas. I mean, Fabled Passage isn't bad. It's obviously fine. I do like Caracas in general. Yeah, let's take Caracas. Why not? Let's see where we go from here. Nowhere good. Ooh, Mizzix's Mastery. I like it. That one I'm glad we put in. Oh, Red Black Talisman, Zealous Conscripts. Oh. This is the cube we have in paper, though. We need to get the cards for the updates we've made. I might just Zealous Conscripts here. No, Pian Colonel Arms too weak to take second pick. Then I don't think that's what I want. Yeah, I like the Lumberjack, though. This isn't the start for it. Yeah, let's take Conscripts. Ooh, Dak Faden and Teferi Time Raveler. Those are both very nice. I think I'll take Dak. And over like Plateau, Nissa, yeah, Teferi. All right. What do we got here? Well, we've got Ulamog. I don't like taking the Eldrazi's before taking the payoffs, like the Sneak Attack or Through the Breach type cards. I do like Spring Bloom Druid a lot. Actually, I've been really impressed with Balakut Awakening so far, but Fires, I think, is cool. It wouldn't be bad with some of these cards so far, but maybe I just will take the Ulamog here. Oh, wow, there's Renin 6 and Bloodstained Mire and Mystic Confluence. Old bordered Mystic Confluence? How can I resist? What can I do, right? I'm just not going to take the Mystic Confluence. Fires, I think, is playable. There's a good chance Fires wheels. What did Louis ask? Oh, if you want to get cards for your own cube, would I recommend you buy them? Well, I would recommend you buy them at channelfireball.com. If you want, you can support the stream by using the code LSV. In general, that's actually a great way to support the stream if you want to. Go to channelfireball.com if you buy, sign up for CFP Pro, buy anything. Just use the code LSV. Let them know I sent you. Hey, what's up, big dog? I like the Triumphs a lot. Red, white, black isn't the one. Like Jeskai Triumph, you know, the Raugrin one, I'd probably be snapping off. Brainstorm not looking as good here as the last time we had it. I think I might just take Glennonald. Glennonald Archmage is a very strong card. I mean, I don't think it's unreasonable to take a Braid there either, but I think Glenn's pretty good. Hey, what's up, Minionad? Welcome. Yeah, the CFP Pro Showdown is coming up this weekend. Fighters is mostly, yeah, like kind of like when it was in standard, a lot of just like powerful, like mid-range threats and not tons of instants. Yeah, I'm not sure about this Ulamog. Ooh, Baleful Strix, I like that one. Commit Memory is pretty good too. Not loving Mystical Tutor here. Spellcaller is a little more interesting than it would normally be because I have this Caracas. Not that it's like guaranteed that I'm going to play white, and you can even splash Caracas without playing white, but kind of feeling this Commit Memory. I would take Vendilion Click over Sheldock Pick 1, Pack 1, but it's pretty close. These are both very good. Yeah, let's just take Commit Memory. We've got a nice start for a Narset deck. Ooh, Lutri the Spell Chaser, Red Green Talisman, Ominato's Augury. Again, a good Storm card, though. We have Storm actually hasn't been opened. Lutri plus Caracas, though? Lutri plus Caracas is just like, that's just not remotely close, right, to being believable. Like, once you, like, you do have to spend the mana to get Lutri into your hand, but once you do, and you're just like sitting there Caracasing your Lutri. Fabled Passage Wield? An indictment on everyone else at the table. Rofellos Wheel too. What are people taking out of this pack? There's also Spellseeker, but given what I have, I'm definitely taking Fabled Passage. I like Mizzix Mastery in some decks. This doesn't look quite like that, whereas Red-Black Talisman could be really good. Oh, wow, Plateau. That's a nice late Plateau. I don't mind a Pyroclasm, but this I'm not going to pass a Plateau this late. Lutri is a free companion, yes. Which, fair warning, I might think it ends up being too gimmicky, but we'll have to see. All right, so Fires of Invention is actually really good with Lutri. Because you can still play Lutri as an instant during your turn. Kind of interested about that. Kind of want Dark Six Shores. I don't think this is looking super young Pyromancery. Take Avacyn. Avacyn Crox is also messed up. So basically, to go back to the Fires thing, you have Fires out. You play a spell for free, then you play Lutri for free and copy it, and then you can still do the thing. Yeah, Plateau did a wheel. I don't know, maybe I should have taken Fires, but I was kind of curious where it went. Ooh, this is actually a library deck, more than most. Don't think I want Upheaval. I've got an Ulamog with nothing to do in my sideboard. So, anyway, Lutri's on the watch list, but I want to try it at least once. And this is a good way to try it. Certainly might not end up surviving. All right, I'll take Library here. Upheaval Fires is synergy. This is true. So you have Fires out, you just tap 6 mana, then you put Upheaval into play for free. Yeah, I'm just going to put Library in hand. All right, I don't hate Kiki with Conscripts. There's a Force of Will as well, and a Steam Vents. Though getting that late Fabled Passage is nice. All right, we should just take Kiki, though. Kiki's going to be... Kiki's good with Fires, too. It's a way to fix for your Kiki here. Yeah, we'll see, Molette. It's a free card, though. Free cards are really good. Like, we played Kahira in our Jeskai Historic deck just as a way to get free stuff, and it's been pretty good. Negate, Through the Breach. Marsh Flats is a red-white land, which is nice. I do have an Eldrazi. Not the Triumph I want here. Kind of am looking at this Marsh Flats because it's a red-white land, which is already nice, and yeah, it makes the black splash better, but also, like, these decks always struggle with their mana. I'm not sure about Conspiracy Theorists. The other thing is, if you ever see, like, a Strixhaven card or even a Kaldheim card, they get a little more latitude because it's like, I wanted to try them out, you know? I do like Negate. I'm going to take Marsh Flats, though. Ooh, Demonic Tutor. All right, I'm glad I took Marsh Flats, because now we can take DT, because we're playing a combo deck, and DT is nice. I'm actually, like, fairly sure I'm going to put Fires of Invention in my deck. Ooh, click Caracas is obviously just absurd. And click's just a great card. But Fires is looking pretty decent here. Ooh, Fires justifies Leovold. I don't really like Chromox too much. Glasspool Mimic. I guess there's Elspeth Conqueror's Death. It's also Grudge, but flashing it back might be a little difficult. I don't know about that. After all, why shouldn't I take Leovold? Glasspool Mimic is good with Fires in some senses, sure. I do like Embercleave for the red aggro decks. Maybe I do take a Mox. Lutri's a good combo with Mox. Turn 3, put Lutri in your hand. Turn 4, Chromox away the Lutri. The other hand, Elspeth Conqueror's Death is pretty nice. Maybe we're just building the old Fires deck. Ooh, this looks like a great Expressive Iteration deck. And I don't think I want Thunder Moss, so. My favorite Talisman of Indulgence. I'm not sure about this Elspeth Conqueror's Death, honestly, but I didn't really like Chromox here. That was an error that the article said opposition wasn't in. Gabby already emailed them to fix it, but I don't know if they saw it. We did not intend to take out opposition. There was a version that didn't have it, but then we ended up wanting it in. Lurrus of the Dream Den, Lightning Helix, Painful Truths, not a combo with Fires. Green-White Talisman. really not the colors I want. I kind of am thinking that Lightning Helix is going to be where I want to be. Blade Splicer. I don't think I'm going to play Night's Whisper. Kind of just want Revoker here. All right, I'll take Impulse. I like K-Command, but I think I'd rather just take Impulse. In the, like, this deck's just looking to it right now. Assemble Kiki Conscripts. We'll see what else we end up seeing. Oh, Breach Wield. Nice. Okay, so Ulamog's back on the table here. Now we have another set of combos, which is nice. Spire Bluff and a Red-White Talisman. Oh, wow. Talismans aren't really a combo with fires, actually. That's the funny thing. I'm just going to take the Spire Bluff. I don't know. Lands, blue-red lands are really, really good. Hey, what's up, lady? Where did I take Elspeth Conqueror's Death over? I'm not looking at this Elspeth. I'm not that likely to want to play Elspeth Conqueror's Death at this point. Chrome Mox? Oh, yeah. I don't think I want a Chrome Mox here either. Red, white, land. Kind of think I want Duress. Yeah. Took it over Mox and Cleave. I don't know why Cleave was mentioned there, but sure. Glasspole Mimic's interesting. I'm not sure what it could be used for. Gristlebrand. Oh, Sneak Attack and Gristlebrand. Brutal. I think I take Sneak because it's so much stronger. Like, to have a Sneak and a Breach and then other targets. And maybe Gristlebrand wheels. Like, maybe Sneak Attack could wheel, but I feel like it's more important to have Sneak. There's also Hallowed Found, which is nice, but I think that's something I can't afford here. I think I'm just going to take Sneak. We'll have to see what ends up. Oh, Resto to go with the Kiki is nice. Plus Resto Click, Resto Glen. Yeah, Resto is just really good here. Yeah. Oh, Deceiver Exarch. Okay. If we can pick up a Splinter Twin, that would be really nice now. Jeskai Splash Black, because I'm going to play this Demonic Tutor. And this Mind Twist. Oh, there's a Venture. Wow, this is actually a tough pack, because look, there's Badlands to make Marsh Flats into... Oh, it's already red. Okay, so Badlands I don't need, because Marsh Flats already prints those things. I think Venture because of the Caracas. And that's part of why I took Lightning Helix so aggressively. This is the kind of card that can kind of get you there. I don't think I can afford to take Mind Twist here. I think I just have to take Venture. Also, like, I think Fires is going to help with this deck. Like, turn four Fires, Venture, they're a thing. Next turn, like, you know, just play two spells or whatever. I think that's going to be good. Okay, Wooded Foothills is red, another red-white land. It doesn't get blue or anything. Don't think Oracle Mole Die is what I want. I don't think I can afford to play Daze. Seasoned Pyromancer could be good just because... I think I'd rather have it as just a cheap play than... Yeah, I don't think... I mean, there's Sun Titan to go with Sneak, but I don't think this deck needs Blood Crypt. I don't think it's really that important. Okay. Another red-white fetch, but again, they're not doing anything but getting red-white. I could take Chandra. I don't think I really need another 4-drop. I think at this point I take the Arid Mesa. I'm glad I took Spire Bluff Canal. The mana is like a little bit awkward. I don't think the Hallowed Fountain is going to wheel. It almost never would does. Though it would be nice if it does, of course. One of those red-black lands might wheel. Oh, Force of Negation. Yeah, I've got enough blue cards. Force of Negation seems like it's going to be really important here. I think I splash black off. Let's see. Marsh Flats, Fabled Passage for a Swamp, Dark Slick Shores. So four black sources. Oh, plus Talisman, 5. Yeah, that should be good. Hey, what's up, Corny Phil? Welcome. Okay. Because, I mean, You can put Lutri into your hand to pitch for the force. I also have 1, 2, 3, 4, Glass Pulse 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah. I would love to wheel Gristlebrand. Let's see. How many cards? This is. We have one card we haven't seen for maybe an Emrakul. But I think picking up a late Eldrazi is more likely than the Gristlebrand wheeling. But Trop doesn't do anything for me, no. Vindicate's a little rough to cast. Auron's Epiphany, Thassa Deep Dwelling. Thassa is pretty nice with conscripts. let's go with Glenn, Venser. Yeah. I think I'm just going to take Vindicate here. I think Epiphany's... Well, I stand corrected. Hallow Fountain Wheeling makes my mana quite a bit better. Okay. That's very nice. Ooh, this is actually going to be, I think, a decent Crystal Shard deck. Red, Black, Tapland, Emery? No, not an Emery deck. Not a Duretti deck either. Let's just take Black Cleave Cliffs. I mean, sure, I'll take Badlands is much better than Black Cleave Cliffs. Probably not playing Mesmeric Fiend or All Sun's Dawn or Goblin Welder. Oh, wow. BK's rolling over in his grave there with that Late Niv-Mizzet here. All right. So what I think I might do is cut the Through the Breach because I have DT and Impulse to assemble the like Ulamog Sneak combo. Plus, Sneak is good with the rest of my cards. Through the Breach is just not very good is the problem, like by itself. Well, sorry. Through the Breach is not good except with exactly Ulamog. Sneak Attack can be good with a lot of the rest of the cards. Let's take out the lands. I mean, I drafted a lot of lands. My mana should be pretty good, I think. This is 27, but we got a lot to... First of all, Lutri goes in the sideboard. Yeah, so let's take out Breach. This does look like a good Fires deck. I'm really interested to see how that plays out. Glasspool mimics a land. So this is 24, and I think I could just play 18 lands with Glasspool Mimic and Library as two of my lands in Caracas, you know. Hey, what's up, Cadaver? Thanks for hanging out here and extending your subscription. Vindicate is in right now. Yeah, I agree with that. I think Revoker's weaker than Vindicate. Vindicate also has the combo with Lutri. Wow, this is going to be, you know, a gassy Lutri deck. I think I can probably cut Duress because I've got Force of Negation and Commit and Glen. Yeah, I think I'd rather cut Duress than side it in if it's good. Though it is also another good combo with Lutri. But I don't think there's anything else here I want less. So, let's see. So, combine groups. Any BK guest plans? No, there's the stream has like some quality standards that it has to uphold. So, really puts me in a bind when it comes to inviting BK onto the stream. Let's see. So, red, blue, red, white, four color cards. So two fetches. Wow, picking up that Hallowed Fountain was a gift. Unbelievable. So this is, I actually might not play the fast lands here. Let's see. Like right now I've got Badlands, Marsh Flats, Arid Mesa. So three. Well, what maybe actually what I do is I play the fast lands and I don't play a swamp. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 block sources. Yeah, plus Fires of Invention. And then... So if I do this, I get to probably play one more island. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6... 10 blue, okay. 2, 3, 4, 5, spots. 7, 8, 9, 10 black, or red rather. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 white. Yeah, no, that actually looks all pretty good. Oh, wait. Island, put a glass pool mimic in. Yeah. Great. This works out. Mm-hmm. The cards I'm most likely, I think, to side in are Phyrexian Revoker, Duress, and I could also see Archangel Avacyn or Elspeth Conqueror's Death, but right now I'm glad to keep those on the sideboard here. Where's the prediction auction for this deck won't win a game? You could predict that, I think. Can I get my thoughts on clones only target your stuff? I think that that's actually a generally good template for clones. I think that cloning the opponent's stuff is definitely smacks of punishing them for putting a cool creature into play. I think it's fine that some of the older clones do that and, you know, whatever, like that's just not a big deal. But I think if you're going to make a clone, you should generally look at your own side of the board rather than theirs. Since it's, I think it's, I mean, it's worse, like it's a lower power level, but I think that it's much cooler to be able to just clone your stuff than free roll off the opponent's good stuff, you know? Hey, what's up, Fowler, and welcome. Here we go. Let's reveal Lutri. And yeah, I'll keep this hand. Obviously, it's not like the best ever. Would have been nice to draw Talisman there. Is it wrong to tell people you have to go to bed because of time zone / work in the morning, even if you have no intention of going to bed anytime soon? Nah, that's not a big deal. It's kind of like your business. Like, whatever you want like to say, I think works out. Actually, let's not play Crystal Shard for two reasons. I would have played it if I drew Force, but there is some amount of like wanting to wait on this card. So they tap out for a creature and you just shard it away. And then now that I can have Force of Negation up, I think that's going to be pretty good. That's fine. Yes, like Sponzi said, saying I should go to bed. It's not a lie. What are the biggest differences between this cube and the last one? I think we cut some like cube staples and also cut some of the like cards that didn't see much play or I think weren't very interesting or good, and then added some cool cards and themes, I think. Okay. I guess I like where this is going, but we'll see what my tune might change once they cast what they cast here. Yeah, I like supporting lands and supporting Blink. I think those are two of the bigger things. No Nykthos. Yeah, Nykthos. Come on. The last cut I made that was painful, I think, was Field of the Dead would have been a sweet one. Do I let them Inquisition me? That's tough. Because, from the one hand, obviously you should just counter it. The other hand, like, I don't really care if they see my hand, and I think that Storm count could matter. So I'd rather than, like, I'm willing to let them look at my hand to make the storm count less good. Okay, they have 3 mana left now. But I don't know who's the IRL trophy leader? We don't really keep track that way. I don't know what they're doing now. I'm definitely putting Duress in, though, I'll tell you that much. And Mesmeric Bean, probably. Probably just put a Swamp in at that point as well. Hey, what's up, Diluted Fruitcake? 56 months. Welcome back. Thanks for hanging out. Hidetsugi's second right is awesome. It leads to such sweet, sweet games. It's not, like, particularly good, but it can be good in mono red. I don't know. Like, I've had games. I don't think Field is necessarily too weak. It's just, like, we just wanted to add the Dark Depths Thespian Stage combo, you know? I don't know if we're going to do a live cube draft in Vegas. That was a lot of... That was tough to do. Okay. Well, I guess I'll do this because I don't think playing Crystal Shard is going to do much for me. Vincer into hand, Helix into the library, Hallowed Fountain. Play Hallowed Fountain. I would not like to pay 2 life. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they did a lot of things there, Molly. I don't really know what their ultimate conclusion is. I think Expressive Iteration is really cool. My only complaint is it's following the way they worded it, but it is so much more intuitive to click on the one you want in your hand, then click on the one you want to play this turn, and then click on the one you don't want. And I wish they had worded it such that that was more of what was going on, you know? Oh, well, I like where we're at now. We picked up 2 nice disruptive cards. Bolus' Citadel. Oh, Professor Onyx. Let's just counter that and draw 2 cards. Yeah, Popot, I think you're right. I think that is also would also be a really good way to go about things. Interesting. They have 1 card in hand. Let's go Crystal Shard and then draw step V-click them. That can't go too wrong, right? We hope. And it's Mind's Desire and nothing else. Good talk, good talk. Let's put in Duress. Mesmeric Fiend. I could put in Revoker, but I don't really want to just raw name Professor Onyx. Let's put in a Swamp. Let's take out a Mountain. Let's take a Lightning Helix and maybe Seasoned Pyromancer, though. That does find me these things. Oh, yeah, we took out Buried Alive, huh? Buried Alive sucked. It wasn't good. I drafted a lot of Reanimator. It wasn't particularly good. Actually, I'll take out Crystal Shard. Crystal Shard's a little slow, and like when they don't have creatures to bounce, it loses a little bit of its luster. Hey, what's up, Gusta? Yeah, you get some live action. What does our deck do? It's red-blue with a couple combos, some control cards. Shard Mesmeric Fiend is very good, this is true, but I think I'd rather focus on speed here. All right. This is a hand where drawing Duress would be so good. Or Force of Negation. Just any way to convert the fact that I'm drawing extra cards off library into Disruption. 3 mana Entomb is still a top 5 card in Reanimator. Well, Entomb's better. Animate Dead is better. Vampiric Tutor is better. Reanimate is certainly better. And Thoughtseize is better. All right, there's probably another 15 cards if you really wanted to go for it, to be honest. Like, I'm not saying I'd never played Buried Alive. I thought it was weak enough that I didn't think the Reanimator deck would miss it. Oh, you like Sans? Yeah, I like... I am a real big fan of Hitotsuga Second Right, for sure. Let's go Hallowed Fountain tapped. Discard Plains and pass. All right, wouldn't mind drawing, a V-click, though this can't get blue because I already have my Hallowed Fountain, fortunately. Oh, a Vindicate? Okay, so we've got a lot of cards. Let's take a turn off to Vindicate here. I'm just going to go after a land. I don't care about the Wishclaw Talisman. Okay, draw. Demonic Tutor, interesting. Arid Mesa, it's funny, I drew my fetch targets. So next turn, so basically the thing is next turn I am going to get to Ulamog them. So I think what I'm going to do here is actually DT for Force of Negation. Play a Mountain and just pass. Doo-doo. Chandra, let's draw a card. Do I Care about Chandra. I think I should counter it because I'm going to get to sneak this turn. Oh, wow. Actually, that's funny. Fires. Sneak out Ulamog. All right, there we go. Deece. Unmarked Grave will be very good. Yes, that's a nice one. Gets a non-legendary creature, which is cool too, because like it means that you're moving away from just Gristlebrand all the time, you know. Play first, reveal a companion. Yeah. They also have Blue Tree, sure. Library go. Hey, later, Kelsey. Off to go shopping? Huh, all right. I guess it's like 7. Yeah, sure. That makes sense. Let's draw. I mean, at some point I will need to draw lands, but this library hopefully gets me there. Oh, yeah. All right. I love Crystal Shard. Talisman, sure. All right. I'm going to upkeep draw. It's kind of sad, but I wanted to hit a land drop. Okay. That's a land drop. That is a land drop. Let's discard Vindicate, I think. They didn't play a land. Okay. I'm just still going to upkeep draw because I really want to hit my lands. And then now I'll play tap out for Crystal Shard because I got nothing better to do. Them missing land drops makes this Crystal Shard pretty nice. Oh, are they going to kill it? Sure. I still will draw an upkeep here. Now we're set. Library eventually does the trick. Let's go. What do we do here? Because I'm not just going to win if I sneak in Kiki. I'm a red source short. I don't really want to get my sneak attack killed. Let's just play Glenn. I could leave up Venser, but like, I don't know. I guess Geddon is the card I'd be worried about. Oh, their own sneak. that's good. I do not need the upkeep stop anymore. So now, I guess I don't actually want to Venser it, funnily enough. I mean, I could just Venser what they play. I could sneak Venser it. Yeah, no, that actually is really good. Never mind. There's a reason Monty does coverage. I don't know what that is, but there is clearly some kind of reason because they let him do coverage. And at some point, I hope to discover it. let's hit. I think this is the safest because I don't get double sneak. Because, I mean, if they play sneak in something and I venture it, and then they just sneak it in again, that could be bad. That was a good line, though. Ooh, I could name Sneak Attack in the mirror. All right, I'm going to take out... I want to take out Helix, which again makes me want to put in Duress. Don't know about Mesmeric Fiend. Or not. Let's just do this for now. I'll leave the... Maybe I want the Plains. Maybe I want the Swamp. Maybe I want neither. I don't know. Molly Lutri's been great so far. I've considered getting Lutri multiple times. I think I'm going to mulligan this hand. Two lander. Doesn't go anywhere. Let's keep this. Put Crystal Shard on the bottom. Part of it is Caracas is really good against sneak attack. And, oh, there we go. And then the impulse means if I draw blue, which I'm going to just crack this to get a Hallowed Fountain, I think. Actually, I'm going to draw to see... I guess I need to crack main phase, but whatever. I was going to draw because if I drew a blue source, I could crack that to get red black, but this is fine too. Do you want to cast Duress? I think it's more important to cast Impulse. And then here, let's see. So if I put Library into hand, nah, let's just get the island. Red would be nice. Just pass. And I think I'm just going to upkeep Deceiver Exarch. Guess I'll tap their swamp. Thanks for gifting a sub to Monty. Appreciate that. Sure. Land. Red, ideally. Okay. Oh, wait. Let's get Lutri. Bam. Molly, we're lined up for a Lutri Duress action here with Caracas back up. Just saying. Just saying. So I don't have Caracas back up here. So I think I'm going to pass because I want to keep up Venser. I think end of turn I'll play Venser. And if they kill Venser, I'll be a little sad, but it's okay. Let's bounce Sacred Foundry. No plays in response, huh? Hey, Snappy Cow with the 2-month resub. Welcome back. Do I wanna let's do it this way. Let's go hold on control, duress them. Lutri in response. They're not playing counterspell colors. Oh, Lutri does it again. I was going to double duress them and then end of turn bounce Lutri and double vindicate them. Wow, Lutri's busted. Wouldn't have come close to winning that game without Lutri, I imagine. Or the fact that they were on 6 mana and just had no castable spells, apparently. I don't really know what they were up to. But I will take it. We're in a little bit of a speed run here. Here we go. All right. Do you have a favorite mustard? Yeah, just Dijon mustard in general is pretty good. What is this hand? Besides mediocre, we can do better than this. This is cube draft. Yeah, I like this hand better. I think I'm going to have to put Resto back, unfortunately. But this hand actually has a curve of things that do anything. Because now I get to... Now I get to go Fabled Passage into Island here. Put a Mulligan to 5. Yee. I've never been to the Mustard Museum. Cube April actually sent me some mustard from Minnesota. That was really good. Let's go Fabled Passage and let's just get our Island here. No Chivo lists. Yeah, that wouldn't have been a bad one. Turn one Tree Speaker. Okay, that's a way to get out of a Molo 5 for sure. Library. I don't think I need to play Library. I guess I could have played Black Cleave Cliffs. In case I drew one of my other fast lands, but I wanted to take less damage. I don't even know. Oh, they're really making up for their mole here. Hopefully their next play is a creature. Otherwise, we're in trouble. Because if we can't... Or not a creature. If we can't Force of Negation, whatever they're going to play on like 6 mana here, which is pretty impressive given they mold to 5, then yeah. Could have put Lutri into my hand, but I just wanted to leave up Force without having to pitch for it. I don't know. Maybe that was wrong. This does not look like a matchup where I'd be boarding in duress. Like, if they just play a Primeval Titan here, we're just done. But if it's like a Primal Command or something, that's a very different thing. Yeah, Vivian Monsters Advocate. That we can handle. The one card left? Okay. Okay. Let's just play Glenn. Don't think playing Deceiver really accomplishes much here. Hey, what's up, Cedric? How's it going, my friend? One card. They have lots of mana. Oh, and they're charging up the Tree Speaker. Kithkin Chief himself. Yeah, I mean, we were pretty dead if they played, like, a creature that cost five or more mana, but obviously they just had a non-creature. Now we've got Mystic Confluence up, which obviously... that's not the best draw, which... obviously can't counter everything, but... I mean, at nine mana, it can counter everything. I just might have to use up some of the card draw equity. Okay, what do we got? Has to be a creature, otherwise the Glen gets it pretty nicely. Canuxa gifting a sub to Cedric. Fair enough. All right, well. Counter, counter, and draw. Mm-hmm. So it's incorrectly displaying here, but it's correctly displaying in our chat. Yeah, I guess we'll just have to use Cryptic. Oh, I like Demonic Tutor. I wish I had another red so I could DT for sneak and know it would work. Oh, would you look at that? All right, let's DT. Let's get sneak. And let's... put Lutri into hand, I think, leaving up Glenn. And then next turn I can play sneak. I need to have Lutri in case I draw something good to sneak in Lutri to copy. All right, they have one turn to draw a creature spell here that does something good. I mean, they're not just dead, but Ulamog is going to eat some lands and chunk them for a bunch of damage here. Oath is out, yeah. Yeah, that was a card. Had to make some cuts, you know? Jace, ooh. I mean, obviously, Jace is Jace, but yeah. Oath of Nissa is sweet, yes. Oh, I guess if we draw Kiki, we would just win, huh? I still remember that Grand Prix where Raph Levy played two Chandra Flame Colors, the double red Chandra, in a green-white deck with absolutely no way to cast it except for Oath of Nissa. He won the GP, too. Mm-hmm. Wait, are they just dead here? Yeah, they are, actually. I think. Oh, and I can tap that. No, I guess they're not just dead, but... Oh, you're having a good time, Bear Force Will? I like it, I like it. I mean, Elspeth Conqueror's Death tends to be pretty good against those kinds of decks. How many white sources do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's kind of a lot. Because that makes me want Archangel and Avacyn and Elspeth Conqueror's Death. So I guess Archangel Avacyn, I don't have that many creatures that actually die, so maybe I don't want that. I still want like the Force of Negation and stuff like that. Let's get rid of maybe Seasoned Pyromancer. It's just, the tokens don't do much against the green decks. I think I've got some good ways to deal with Jace here. Yes, it was at PTSOI Mole. I was playing against Steve Rubin, who ended up going on to win that pro tour, and he cast a Gideon off of like four lands that couldn't cast Gideon normally, but he had Oath of Nissa, and I'm like, I guarantee you right now, Twitch chat is asking how you cast that Gideon. That was great. It was fantastic. Lutri instrumental to yet another victory. Ooh, I like this hand. Fires of Invention look like it might come up big here. I might have to DT for a land here. Hey, what's going on, Brad? So Brad, did you work on Modern Horizons 2? I wasn't sure. But did that end up happening? Okay, well there's my combo card. Nice. Coming up with your Asmoran, Daculars, and Ignoble Hierarchs. Hey, what's up, Gabby? All right. Once again, I'm asking you to cast a creature spell and not a non-creature spell. Well, I'm going to Demonic Tutor here, and I think I'm going to get a red mana. I mean, how wild is it to get, like, Marsh Flats? So the reason I get Marsh Flats is this gives me the option next turn of getting red or blue mana, depending on what I think is more valuable. Because I only need a single red for fires. So if I draw a red source, I want to be able to get a blue and Vendilion click them. Oracle of Moldiah. Turn 3 Oracle. We already had Relox, no worries. They haven't played lands. Oh, and then they get to play a Prismatic Vista. Yeah. This is rough. We need some help. Oh, I should have just gotten Spire Bluff Canal. Yeah, that was that wasn't great, was it? Let's just chill. So they're drawing an Explore, which is obviously a good draw. Okay. Harmonize. And they have a mount. So since they have a land on top anyway, this is actually doesn't cost us too much. But yes, definitely should have gotten Spire Bluff Canal. That may end up costing us if we don't draw a red here. Still going to click them. Their hand is Biogenic Ooze, Toski, Bearer of Secrets. Oh, I'm going to take Toski for sure. Oh man, Karn. Karn is a yikes too. Karn means that, let's see, so their hand right now is those two plus a forest. I guess we'll see what they do. Pretty hard not to cast Harmonize here, but obviously they know about Force of Negation from a previous game. So they're just going to go with the Biogenic Ooze. All right. So next turn, they have one card in hand. It's Harmonize. They're going to draw a Karn. Yeah, I'll take it. Thing is, with a Karn on top, yeah, I don't know. If I were them, I think I probably would have just cast the Harmonize, but okay. Ugh, talismans here, huh? Yeah, I guess we'll play Talisman of Indulgence. That's brutal. A red land there, and we get to cast Fires plus... Well, actually, I don't even know if I would have cast Fires there, because I do kind of need to counter whatever they play this turn. I think I pitched the Exarch here, because I think I still need to keep Commit in hand. Oh, this is definitely winnable, especially if they don't hit lands, or I would draw a way to kill Oracle or something here. Because they can't even attack with both Oozes this turn, unless they want to lose this one. Which means that they'll attack with one. And... I mean, I guess they could attack with everything, but yeah, they're just going to attack with one. Now I'm just going to block, and I'm just taking so much less damage. Oh, really? I think that's trading for Oracle's good here. We know their last card is Harmonize, yeah. Mountain, okay. Let's go Fires of Invention. Commit your Biogenicas. What? Wait, am I doing this wrong? Oh, duh. All right. Pass the turn. I don't know about that attack with the Oracle. Now they draw Terastan. They can cast Harmonize this turn. I just need to draw a land. All right. That's not too hard to ask for. Wow, so I can cast Memories, actually a pretty nice combo with Fires too. This would be a sweet game to win. And for once, even a tap land does work. Unfortunately, a cantrip doesn't because I'm still restricted by two spells here. And this is also assuming, I guess, that they don't have an interactive spell this turn, but... Oh, Conscripts, actually. Huh. I don't need a Conscript to land into Memory. I just need a Conscript to land into Kiki Jiki. Wow, it just blew my mind. Broken Pipe, that was a great call. Hey, thanks for the raid, Zen. Appreciate it. Zen is the captain of Team Lotus Bucks. I believe that's the name. And has a lot of cool deck lists. I have to admit, whenever you win a tournament, which is frequently, I do take a look at the decks. So, boom, boom, boom. Oh. Or we needed nothing. Cast with Fires. Cast with Fires. Conscripts. Kiki. Yeah, the top deck in the land was so much less cool before we knew the combo, but there we go. That was a fast little trophy there, and wha-bam. Thanks for watching. This was a sweet little draft, a little 52-minute draft. Nice. Don't mind that at all. Once again, these drafts are sponsored by Ultimate Guard, sponsored Team CFB, and that will be a wrap. Thanks for watching, and check out channelfireball.com for more drafts like this one.